Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Gettysburg High School for our 129th commencement ceremony. At this time, we would request that all electronic devices be turned off or to a silent mode. Please be reminded that school board policy prohibits the use of air horns and similar noisemakers in our auditorium. Violators will be removed from the building. At the conclusion of commencement, please remain at your seats until the graduates and faculty have recessed from the auditorium. Thank you for protecting the integrity of the ceremony and the safety of all persons in attendance tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise, remain standing, and gentlemen, remove your hats as the Gettysburg High School Army JROTC Warrior Battalion Color Guard enters the auditorium to present our nation's colors. The national anthem will be performed this evening by senior Miss Lucy Pratt.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were
the Gettysburg High School's Class of 2015 graduation ceremony. My name is Sierra Lookaville, and as class president, I am pleased and honored to welcome all of the faculty, staff, friends, and family who have helped foster and support the education of the graduates here on stage this evening. On behalf of the graduates, I thank you all. Tonight marks the final recognition of our class as a whole for not only our accomplishments, but our experiences and futures. I know that I, and my peers as well, feel incredibly grateful to have received an education when so much of the world does not have the same opportunity. No matter the hours studied or time spent on work, we are all here on stage tonight, able to celebrate the completion of an education that has prepared us to achieve and create positive change. This graduation is the monumental closure of our high school career, but at the same time, a new beginning and an ability to start fresh. The frightening but also wonderful thing about the future is that it's completely unknown. The possibilities are endless, and I hope, my fellow graduates, that as you begin this new chapter, you remember that this is only the beginning of a life filled with success and opportunity. Thank you. Fiona O'Dowd to speak. Fiona is the daughter of Karen and Timothy O'Dowd and was chosen to speak by the top decile of our class. She was the captain of the speech and debate team, vice president of Key Club, and is actively involved in service activities with the Hugh O'Brien Youth Leadership Organization. Fiona will be attending Purdue University in the fall to study materials engineering.
Good evening, family, friends, faculty, and most importantly, fellow classmates of the Gettysburg High School class of 2015. For the past year, we've all been pushed to think of the future like never before. The focus is on what's ahead and what we plan on doing for the rest of our lives. Now, like never before, we are able to fully appreciate the broad scope of possibilities for the future, where we can work towards our goals and aspirations to find a meaningful place in the world. We, as individuals, possess the power to affect the lives of ourselves and those around us through our actions, however small. The future is ours, and with it, we can change the world. I'd like to begin by sharing a parable that many of you have probably heard before, the starfish story. An old man walks along a beach covered in tens of thousands of starfish, which have washed ashore. In the distance, he sees a young boy picking up starfish and gently tossing them back in the ocean. The man approaches the boy and asks him, "Why are you throwing the starfish?" The boy replies, "The sun is hot, the tide is low, and if I do nothing, the starfish will die." The old man begins to laugh at the young boy, saying, "You must be crazy. There are miles and miles of beach, all covered in starfish. You couldn't possibly save all of them. Even if you work for the entire day, your efforts won't make any difference at all." The boy listens to the man, then calmly tosses another starfish into the ocean, saying, "I made a difference for that one." When I first heard that story, I think it was on the last day of a class with Ms. Kubek, I was pretty uninspired by it. It was just another one of those cutesy stories that was theoretically supposed to have some profound effect on my outlook on life, right? But then I started hearing the starfish story again and again, and a whole lot of situations. So it was obviously either a really important message or just the first result when you Googled inspirational story, which it's not. I checked. The idea that even the smallest actions can have an incredible effect shows the breadth of our power as individuals. If each individual action can have a significant effect on its own, imagine the possibilities if we all work together to achieve our dreams. Every significant thing in the world, the most innovative technology, the most grand humanitarian effort, the most evocative work of art, came from people who are just like us. They too were once bewildered teenagers, soon to be thrust into the adult world. There's a quote I'm sure many of you recognize from The Lorax. "Unless someone like you cares a whole awful lot, nothing is going to get better. It's not." By itself, that's not a particularly positive thought. It skirts being almost doomsday. However, from it, we can gather that if someone like us does care a whole awful lot, then we can make a lasting, positive difference in the world around us. The power to promote change lies not only in the world of CEOs, politicians, and Nobel laureates, both each and every one of us. So we have all this potential, but in the words of humanitarian Dr. Albert Schweitzer, what are you going to do with this? How will we take charge of our future and promote everlasting change? We do have the power to make a difference in the world, no matter how small. Everything we do affects the people around us, whether we want it to or not, and it's now our responsibility to use that power. We have spent the last 13 years preparing for today, the ending of our grade school education and the celebration of what we've accomplished so far in our lives. Whether we're going to college, joining the military, or entering the workforce, we can leave here today knowing we have what it takes to make a lasting difference in our future. Thank you.
Thank you.
student speaker is Quan Quan Nguyen. She is the daughter of Angela and Charlie Nguyen. Quan Quan was chosen by administration to speak this evening. She played varsity tennis, participated in key club and orchestra, and was the president of the National Honor Society. Quan Quan will be studying medicine at the University of Pennsylvania starting this fall.
For the third time tonight, good evening, and thank you all for being here. I know many of you have traveled far to be here for a graduation, and I would like to sincerely thank you all for being here. Gettysburg brings a variety of people to its quaint atmosphere and beautiful scenery. Some have migrated from outside the state to settle in this town, while some have stayed here for many family generations. That wasn't the case for me, though. My family came from an entirely different country 19 years ago from the other side of the world. One of their main reasons for immigrating to this country was for the educational opportunities here that would not have been as easily obtained in Vietnam. The simple things that my classmates and I took for granted, my parents took in with amazement. They were surprised that for all my years in elementary school, I was offered art classes, music classes, and a surplus of sports from middle school into high school. The resources and hands-on learning I had in classrooms and the technology literally at our fingertips with laptops and cell phones was not obtainable when my parents were in high school. This was the first year that everyone in the school had a laptop. Yeah, we were the beta testers, the guinea pigs, the ones who experienced everything wrong with the laptops so they could fix it for future classes. My parents were amazed at the advanced level of our educational system, and they hoped that I would greatly benefit from it. Despite the differences in opportunities, my parents did see some similarities between their high school culture in Vietnam and here in Gettysburg. As students were allowed to ride their bikes and walk to school in Vietnam, we are allowed to drive our cars to school. While the amount of parking space isn't as big of a problem, the parking skills of some of the students is. Both cultures have difficulty waking up before noon, and getting into school on time is even more of a hassle, especially when the doors to the gym aren't open in the morning anymore. It takes me 4 minutes to run with my laptop strapped to my back, past the gym doors, to the office, and to my homeroom upstairs, which is conveniently above the gym doors. We all struggle together, whether we knew it or not, in classes, in social groups, and in general life. And now, we are all taking a step forward in our lives, not having the slightest idea what we will be doing for the next few years. Unless you're my good friend, Drew. Like half of the time, my parents are right. I did find something at Gettysburg, and I did benefit from it. My journey through high school has not only taught me the academics necessary for life, but it also given me a foundation to push myself to reach my potential. Cliche, I know. Some days, I felt like all I ever did was mindlessly stare at the Promethean board in Mr. Harvey's class with the lights dimmed and a soothing voice in the background encouraging me to sleep. But for the majority of the days, I knew that I was becoming more prepared for the future. For the most part, it's true that I worked hard and had a drive to do well, but a large part of it was also due to the people that have always supported me. So, on behalf of my class, I would like to thank all of our former teachers and faculty, our families, and our friends. It is through your hope in not only wanting us to do well in our classes, but also in our futures that we are here today on stage. I would like to shout out to Mr. Godak, who couldn't be here tonight, but was always there with his enthusiasm and knowledge whenever I needed help, which was often. Despite my references to some of our dubious school policies, and despite our struggle to get along with one another, I think that it is important to remember that we all have something in common. We're all taking a step forward in our lives, and we all don't know what the heck we're doing. Whether we're going to college, the military, vocational or trade school, or just starting right off in the workforce, most of us don't know where the next few years will take us, and I think that's perfectly okay. Trust me, my parents never imagined they would be moving halfway across the world when they graduated high school. Maybe in high school, we all thought we were the only ones struggling in class. We were the only ones feeling left out. or we were the only ones that cared, but it wasn't true. We were all in the same boat, but we just didn't know it. I guess what I want to say is that it's okay to feel uncertain, to feel confused, or even to feel scared of the future, but just know that you're not alone. And with whatever paths we choose to take, we will have the support of each other, our friends and family, and even many of our former teachers, just like for the past 13 years in our lives. We're all in this together, so congratulations, class of 2015. Thank you.
Good evening. I'd like to deviate momentarily from the program and invite Mr. Blanchard, Mr. Lewis, and Mr. Lusk to join our school board members on the center stage, please. School board members, if you would please come as I read a proclamation of appreciation to the students, the teachers, and the staff and principals at Gettysburg Area High School for the U.S. News and World Report classification as one of the best high schools in the nation. It is my pleasure to read this proclamation from the board. Whereas the U.S. News and World Report publication annually identifies and recognizes the best high schools in the nation, and whereas during the 14-15 school year, the U.S. News and World Report reviewed over 29,000 high schools in the nation, and whereas the criteria used by the U.S. News and World Report publication included proficiency in English, math, social studies, and science subjects as part of graduation requirements for high school, and whereas the criteria included the number of students who have the opportunity to take advanced placement coursework and exams, and the participation rate at Gettysburg Area High School is 30%. And whereas the criteria used by the U.S. News and World Report publication includes college readiness, and the Gettysburg Area School District and High School received a silver rating, and whereas for the 14-15 year, the Gettysburg Area High School was recognized by the U.S. News and World Report as one of the top 10% public high schools in Pennsylvania. And whereas the efforts of the students, staff, teachers, principals of Gettysburg Area High School contributed to the academic, behavioral, and social successes of our district, be it therefore proclaimed that the Gettysburg Area Board of Directors recognizes the tremendous efforts of the students, the teachers, staff, and principals of Gettysburg Area High School for their commitment to the academic success of our district. Congratulations, students and staff.
I guess I go off script a little bit there for a minute. I want to thank the Board of Directors this evening for recognizing the work of the faculty and the staff, and especially you, the students here at Gettysburg High School. The purpose of our work is not to make anyone's top 10 list. However, it is an important validation for what we are trying to do here at Gettysburg, to provide for the students of this community the opportunity and the tools to experience success in the midst of a challenging world. And this honor is especially apropos this evening, as the test scores and accomplishments that led to our recognition, those test scores were earned by the students on this stage in the class of 2015. I want to thank the teachers and the support staff, those of you in the back there, for all you have done to support these students. And seniors, I want to congratulate you for the very significant role that you played in this honor tonight. Well, good evening. Back on script now a little bit. My name is Mark Blanchard, and it is my privilege to serve this community as the high school principal. Tonight, while we recognize all of our students for their special accomplishment, we confer special honor on 20 of them. You will see noted on the center panel of your program a group of students identified as our Scholastic Honor Group. The Laude designation is Latin and means honor. Cum laude means with honor and is reserved at Gettysburg for those who graduate in the top 10% of their class. Magna cum laude means with high honor and is for those who graduate in the top 5%. And finally, you will see three of our students graduating summa cum laude with highest honor. These are for students who finish in the top 2%. We honor Andrew, Fiona, and Quan Quan for their special accomplishment this evening. These students will receive medals tonight for this accomplishment, along with their diploma. Seniors, tonight I have the privilege and opportunity to speak to you on one of the most important and significant days of your young lives. I'm sure that your specific memory of these words will quickly fade after tonight's ceremony, but I still want to share a simple and brief truth with you tonight. Many of you know that I began my career as an English teacher. Unlike most people, I actually enjoyed reading Shakespeare, but I enjoyed even more reading it with high school juniors and seniors. There's a reason that Shakespeare is still around 400 years after he first started composing his tragedies and comedies. The truths that he explores are universal. They stand the test of time, and they reveal the challenges common to all of us. One of the greatest of his works, one that perfectly illustrates this point, is Macbeth. If you remember, Macbeth was a Scottish lord and war hero. He had successfully protected his king and friend, Duncan, from a rebellion. Macbeth was rich, powerful, and honored by his king. But that wasn't enough for him. Many of you remember the rest of the story. Macbeth, encouraged by his wife, went on a murderous rampage. He killed Duncan while he slept in his bed. He killed guards. He killed friends. He had the children of his enemies and rivals killed, all because he wanted more. More power, greater riches, just simply more. And he would pursue these things at any cost. It is in Act 3, Scene 2, that we find the words which first struck me as a college student and have remained with me since. Lady Macbeth, contemplating all of the carnage around them, utters these words: "Naught's had, all's spent, where our desire is got without content. 'Tis safer to be that which we destroy than by destruction dwell in doubtful joy." Naught's had. Lady Macbeth acknowledges that despite having the throne and all that goes with it, they really have nothing. All's spent. In the end, they spent everything they had of value, their integrity, their morals, pursuing these desires. And ultimately, she realizes that while they may have attained their desire, it is without satisfaction. Seniors, you have been successful. You were one of the most decorated classes during my 7 years as principal. But tonight, I want to challenge you to think differently about your success. I urge you, pursue excellence, chase greatness, seek to be successful, but be very careful about the measures you use to define these things. Material accomplishment is a siren song. Do not seek these things as an end to itself. These things should not be the goal, but rather the means towards a deeper, more meaningful life. You have the ability to pursue greatness. But greatness will never be defined by material possession. Greatness comes from using your accomplishments to make the world in which you live, your sphere of influence, a better place. Too often we see the pursuit of things leading to destructive behavior. Shakespeare knew this. It's the core truth behind Macbeth, and the truths of the early 1600s remain true today. Tonight, you are well equipped. You have all of the raw materials necessary, but avoid the mistakes of the Macbeths. Be careful what you choose to pursue. I think you will find great contentment can be measured in the type of family you create, the parents you become, the community member that you grow into. Many of you saw this in action just 1 week ago at our awards ceremony and scholarship night, when you served as the beneficiaries of so many in this community choosing to give of themselves to use their accomplishments to serve others rather than themselves. This afternoon, as I was meeting with one of our teachers for his end of year evaluation, he shared with me a statement he made to one of his students earlier this week. When the student asked if the teacher would remember them, the teacher replied, "Of course." But he added this important qualifier. He shared that he will not at all remember how the student scored on that final exam, but he would remember always the type of person that student was. As he said that, I had flashbacks to students from my days as a teacher at Central Dauphin High School. How true. I don't remember anyone's grades, but I remember very well their qualities. I will remember the qualities exhibited by students like Emily Hessler, a student who accumulated more than 250 volunteer hours this year for the Interact Club, the student extension of Rotary International. I don't know exactly what Emily's grades look like. I'm sure they're fine. But is there anyone who doubts that an attitude of service like that is setting her up for success? Or a student like Giselle Batances. Giselle sits here in the front row as one of our honored students. But very few here will remember that exactly about Giselle. What we will remember is one of the nicest, most caring students I have ever known, a student who was honored this year as our North Star Student of the Year for her acts of service to the school community and to the students here. These are measures of success. These are the things that truly last. As I close tonight, I have no delusions that my specific message to you will ring in your ears. But I do hope that you internalize this one simple concept. The pursuit of things is a losing journey because you will find that it is never enough. Rather, you are all gifted in a special way. Use those gifts to pursue excellence in your relationships and service to others. These are choices you will never regret. I know I can speak for Mr. Lewis and Mr. Lusk in congratulating you on this accomplishment tonight. You have shown all of us that you can do it. Now remember this feeling of success and begin to replicate it as you move forward. In doing so, you will find a life of great fulfillment, and you will become a model for those who follow. My best to you. And now, on behalf of the administration of Gettysburg Area High School, I am proud to present to the Board of School Directors and to you, Dr. Redding, the graduating class of 2015.
Alita Neary. Alexis Chavero. Maria Rebecca Duff. Daniel Arthur Elizada. Lucy Alyssa Edwards Pratt. Sierra Lee Lookabill. Andrew Yanello Dalton, cum laude. Caitlin Taylor Grimes, cum laude. Matthew Allen Wagner, cum laude. Grace Ann Redmond, cum laude. Tyler Hogan Lampe, cum laude. Casey Stacy Christine Little, magna cum laude. Madeline Joy Sonnet, magna cum laude. Rebecca Michelle Fosnot Fisher, magna cum laude. Josiah Levi Davidson, magna cum laude. Fiona Bridget O'Dowd, summa cum laude. Presenting Fiona's diploma is her mother, high school faculty member Karen O'Dowd. Andrew James May, summa cum laude. Presenting Andrew's diploma is his mother, middle school secretary Lori May. Quan Quan Dam Nguyen, summa cum laude. John Weiler Ulig, magna cum laude. Kelly Lynn Garman, magna cum laude. Jesse Hanren Shu, magna cum laude. Olivia Ann Gieseman, cum laude. Colin Lloyd Bortner, cum laude. Madeline Ray Maloney, cum laude. Sydney Elizabeth Brewer, cum laude. Giselle Lucy Batances, cum laude. Jenna Marissa Taylor. Timothy Joseph Zerbini. Caitlin Leanne Shriver. Christopher Joseph Ziegler. Janet Blanco. Val Brack. Maggie Catherine Fies. Zachary John Giannis. Caroline Grace Hunley. Kenton Edward Arnold. Alexis Marie Franick. Kyle Allen Weishar. Shauna Brooke Baggett. Thomas Michael Inglesby. Justice Brianna Brooks. Cody Allen Yoder. Joseph Quaid. Rosalinda Garcia. Mitchell Adam Hoffman. Grace Elizabeth Dolan. Kevin Edward Bachmore. Floor Stephanie Lua. Ethan Garrett Tipton. Monica Ann Fleshman. Isaiah Pascal Thurley. Joanna Mendez. Christian Alexander Valley. Savannah Suzanne Height. Ty Anthony Sherman. Emma Mackenzie Baum. Lane Michael Sherman. Nicole Marie Hallbrand. Samuel Richard Fetter. Madeline Lane Mueller. Blake Garrison Holden. Monica Ramirez. Ramiro Diaz. Olivia Ann Deckard. Presenting Olivia's diploma are her father and I, teachers at Gettysburg High School. Matthew Alejandro Suarez. Sarah Beth Bailey. Nathan Michael Shara. Tara Ray Bankert. Jonah Christian Walkenig. Alexis Brianna Namius. Brandon William Glorioso. Greta Rose McNally. Woo! Wyatt Oscar Cluck. Emily Kate Hessler. Ethan Cole Yoder. Amber Lauren Wenshoff. Brendan Tyler Martin. Sasha Marie Angel. Colby Douglas Newton. Cassandra Lynn Rosado. Marco Antonio Romero. Emily Megan Hemler. Chance Reno Turner. Megan Arlita Schaefer. Kelso James Riley. Shay Pearson Whiteman. Marshall Jeremiah Davidson. Ashley Cassandra Perez. Christian Josiah Priel. Presenting Christian's diploma is his father, school board member, Dr. David Priel. Shannon Nicole Helfrick. Wade David Lotteman. Hannah Nicole Gardner. Micah Christian Sunholm. Caroline Hart Krishan. Marcos Diaz Rico. Caitlin Renee Walker. Dalton Nicholas Lyons. Larissa Marie Gardner. Nelson Kirk Richards. Shauna Jean Feaster. Wyatt Raymond Culver. Sydney Renee Tomasini. Carl Philip Souders. Elizabeth Ann Wilson. Aaron James Scruggs. Christina Marie Hazlett. Giovanni Almanza Alvarado. Anya Grace Kosha. Robert Paul Dubs IV. Marissa Lynn Brazy. Keith Allen Startsman. Amber Christine Dickerson. Damian Michael McLaughlin. Gabrielle Paige Borndorf. Owen Michael Young. Grace Marie Garland. Cody Allen Grimes. Elizabeth Ann Crane. Tyler Patrick Clemens. Kelsey Ann Wendell. Ryan Thomas Kresge. Summer Sierra Williams. Brandon Luther Smith. Sunday Rose Cooksey. Kevin Daniel Constellid. Samye Piyush Viramgama. Brett William Briggs. Sarah Elizabeth Drowski. Kobe Michael Wansel. Abigail Marie Smuda. Killian Mitchell Osorin. Abigail Nicole Strine. Tyler Lynn Moritz. Iris Natalie Rattenfusser. Thaddeus Joseph Paul Fravel. Hannah Nicole Skirvin. Mackenzie Wilson Kretz. D. Deja Simone Mincy. Hunter Lookabill. Ashley Nicole Haynes. James Edward Greenelch. Haven Alexandria Smith. Sean Philip McElhose. Cheyenne Haley Grimm. Nikos Alexandros Koufos. Lauren Christina Daniels. Joshua James Decker. Olivia Ann Neubauer. Skylar Justice Middow. Danielle Elizabeth Cool. Michael Allen Zinn Jr. Katya Promsuwan. Justin James Kinsius. Cortland Brianne Cullison. Colton Russell McLaren. Ann Stanton Matthews. Michael James Heeshan. Katie Marie Dutrow. Frederick Graham Hardman. Benjamin Thomas Price. Stephanie Ann Commons. Frank Emmanuel James Everson. Brooke Hannah Myers. Timothy Allen Biersma. Jacqueline Nicole Wolf. Derek Michael Andrzejczyk. Jordan Nicole Lyon. Jordan Andrew Williams. Kiernan McCree Newman. Brett Michael Weichert. Deprecia Lakira Griffin. Michael Timothy Johnson. Marissa Lynn Swint. Tyler Jacob Herring. Kayla Marie Mayers. Sean Anthony Hager Jr. Montana Ray McGee. Benjamin Tucker Klingensmith. Elena Marie Kunkel. Jacob William Shara. Emily Jean Arrowwood. Nathaniel Allen Easter. Tia Renee Stull. Douglas Eugene Sense Jr. Ashlyn Marianne McCready. Logan Michael Shedder. Megan Ann Jordan. Jacob Parker Myers II. Presenting Jacob's diploma is his mother, High School Secretary Maria Myers. Allison Nicole Fritz. Alexis Jade Rothermel. Caroline McKinley Hartzell. Kylie Marissa Gallagher. Heather Nicole Strasbaugh. Morgan Christine Boyd. Monica Nicole Brittany Green. Susanna Wise Abilene. Briar Alexander O'Neill Baum. Lauda Sanchez. Lucas Charles Walslack. Katie Trish Scherer. Jose Mendez. Chantel J. Wormsley. Dominic Lamar Allen Griffin. Hadley Morgan Waybright. Zachary Michael Wozlak. Mary Tessa Hardman. Jordan Rashawn Turner. Kelsey Elizabeth Kohler. William Winfield Haynes Sauter. Jasmine Hernandez Hernandez. Mary Elizabeth Dingle. Caitlin Rochelle Carmack. Kiana Mae Johnson. Madeline Louise Yannetti. Lynette Molinex.
Will the class of 2015 please rise? In accordance with the standards of the Pennsylvania Department of Education, and the policies and regulations of the Gettysburg Area Board of School Directors, by the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, it is my honor and pleasure to declare the 129th class of the Gettysburg Area High School graduates. You may now move your tassel to the left. Congratulations. Thank you.